Hello everyone. In the previous session of Introduction to Animal Classification, that is in the paper Non-Chordates of the Animal Kingdom, we have discussed what do you mean by taxonomy and Linnean hierarchy and different types of the classifications, and we studied about eminent people who gave their prominent knowledge towards the classification. So in this session, we'll be studying about the level of organizations and different types of systems or the symmetry in this session. So coming to the body plans, so here the cell aggregate plan. So it is nothing but the cluster of cells that are forming a body. For example, if you take a sponge or porifera, usually the whole body is made up of a single type of cells. So that is called as cell aggregate plan. And second one, blind sac plan. So here, single cavity, so that is endocele. Endo means inside. The coelom which is present inside with one opening for both mouth and anus. So here also you can give the example for sponges. So if you have seen the structure of sponge, the mouth and the anus will be the same. So in coming session, we will be studying about detailed about porifera. So that time I will show you the structure of sponges. And tube within tube plan. So one tube here refers to body wall and another is referring to the alimentary canal. So usually here we are having two openings. One is mouth and another will be the anus. So this is how the body plans are constructed. So you need to know very two important terminologies, that is deuterostome and protostome. So deuterostome is nothing but anus will be formed first in the embryo. Proto, so deutero is end, proto means the starting. So starting portion will be the head, so it consists of mouth. So they have called the protostomes as mouth forms first. And interdeterminate cleavage. So here the cleavage is nothing but the division of embryo or becoming two-celled to four-celled to four-celled to eight-celled. So those different types of embryological changes that takes place inside the mother during the cleavage. So later we are having examples for deuterostomes like echinodermates and chordates. But whereas in protostomes, where mouth will be formed first, like sponges and mollusks. So this you should know the difference between deuterostomes and protostome. And this is very important, level of organization. So we all know that we are made up of our minute structure, that is cell. But before that, the cell is made up of minute molecules like DNA and RNA, proteins, lipids, and water content. So those are also very important to make up our body. So molecules, cells, tissue, organ, organ system, and organization. So these are the different levels our body is made up of. So as you can see, the cellular level of organization, the cells are arranged as loose cell aggregates. So usually in sponges, so they are made up of the single type of cells. So they belong to cellular level of organization. And coming to tissue, the arrangement of cells is more complex. And here the cells performing same functions are arranged into tissues. So examples are the cylindrates. And coming to the organ level of organization, here the tissue is replaced by organs. So different types of tissue, they merge together to form organs. So this is exhibited by the members like platyelminthes and other higher phyla, which where tissues are grouped together to form the organ. So usually examples are platyelminthes. Coming to the organ system, so we know each organ, they combine together to form an organ system, like lungs, which gives to the respiratory system, and heart comes to the circulatory system. So here they are many very much larger animals like coming to annelida, arthropod, mollusk, echinodermata, and also the chordates or the vertebrates. So each organ, they are associated to form the functional system. So each system, they are consist or they are concerned with the specific physiological function. So as I was telling, the respiration, lungs, the windpipe, trachea, they makes a prominent organ and which work for the common cause, that is a physiological function. So this is nothing but the same how the our body, it is made up of atom, and later protoplasm will be formed, later cellular level of organization and tissues, organ level, organ system level and organism level. So this is how we are made up of. And coming to the digestive system, so digestive system, our digestive tract is nothing but a passage where food is taken, like digestion, absorption, elimination of undigested food has to take place. But we should know there are two different types of digestive system. One is incomplete digestive system and one is complete digestive system. So cylindrates and flatworms, they are having digestive tract with a single opening. So usually we call them as the mouth that takes food as well as eliminates the undigested food. So that is why we tell them as incomplete digestive system. So digestive tract, maybe animals, there are two openings. So if it is having two openings, one for food and one for eliminating the undigested food, then we'll call them as complete digestive system. So this is where how we are classifying two different types of digestive system as complete digestive system and incomplete digestive system. Coming to circulatory system. So circulatory system is also of two types. One is open circulatory system and another one is closed circulatory system. As you can see in the picture, open circulatory system, the blood flows in open sacs like lacuna and sinus. If you know the structure of lacuna and sinus, which will be present in insects, so there the blood will be flowing outside. So what happens, the cells will be exposed directly. But whereas in closed circulatory system, the blood circulate inside the blood vessels, maybe in veins or arteries, they will never come with the direct contact with the body cell. So this is how the two different types of circulatory system we are having. One is closed circulatory system and another is open circulatory system. So as I was telling, in closed circulatory systems like annelids and chordates, and open circulatory systems which is seen in insects, that is arthropods and mollusks. So as we should know these important terminologies, where blood may be colorless in insects, so that is why we call them as and also they are having a blue color pigmentation, so that is hemocyanin, and red color in humans or the vertebrates due to the respiratory pigment, that is hemoglobin. So and certain animals, they do not have any color. So this is how the color classification also takes place. Coming to very important system, that is types of symmetry. So as you can see in the picture, asymmetrical, radial symmetrical, bilateral symmetrical. So what do you mean by asymmetrical? Sponges, if you cut it any portion, maybe in bilateral or radial, so what happens, the size will be different, so they cannot be cut into equal half. So that is why we call it as asymmetrical. So as you can see in radial symmetrical, if you take in any axis, then it will be differentiated into two equal half. But bilateral symmetrical, it has to take cut place in the longitudinal way. That is how when the body planes can divide along plane that splits animal body into right and left side as a mirror image. For example, if you cut a human being from head to his tail, so it is a mirror image. So we humans are also bilateral symmetry. So as I was telling, they are classified into three different types. First one is asymmetry, when the body is not visible into equal half or divisible into equal half, that is asymmetry. Example, like if you take amoeba, it is irregular in shape. If you cut, there is no mirror image formed, so that is asymmetry. And coming to radial symmetry, so in radial symmetry, what happens, the number of similar part radiates out into central axis. So it has to pass through the central axis and can be divided into two equal half at any plane passing through the center from top to bottom. Example, starfish or the sea anemone. And next, bilateral symmetry. So here what happens? It can be divided into two equal half by single plane only because of the important body organs are paired and they occur in two sides and the central axis. Example is the vertebrates. So this is how three different types of body planes are present. So these are the important terminologies we need to know as sagittal section, frontal section, transverse section and median section. So see, in the first diagram, if it is cut into equal half from the center, so that is called as median plane or sagittal median plane. And backside, if it is cut like from the shoulder region, then it is the frontal part is the front region. So that is called as frontal or coronal. And transverse is nothing but in the T, like as T stands for how the T letters stand, like the top portion is cut into equal half. And sagittal section at the pelvic cavity. So as you can see, the pelvic region, what are the organs present. And in the frontal section of the thoracic cavity in the lungs, so you can see the lungs, so that is if it is cut through the upper portion, so that is the frontal section. And transverse section, like if you cut the exact half of the head, so you can make out the brain region and eye region, how it is connected to the our brain. Coming to germ layers. So germ layers are also very important. This question can be asked for 2 marks. What are germ layers? They are nothing but the primary layers of the cell which differentiate into animal embryo that during the gastrulation. So if you have known little about the embryology, like gastrulation, blastulation, neurulation, so this you will be studying in detail in your final year also. So you should know, during the gastrulation stage, our embryo, it will divide our cells, like different types of layers are present inside our body, like endoderm, mesoderm and the ectoderm. So 3 different layers will be formed. So that is how during the gastrulation takes place. So these germ layers are very, very important, and these germ layers give rise to all the tissues. For example, the first one, diploblastic. So diplo means what? There are 2 regions. So that is diploblastic organisms. So usually diploblast means they are having only 2 layers. So diploblast. So you can see in the diagram, gut, endoderm and ectoderm. So that is the diploblastic coelomates. And triploblastic coelomate, gut region is also present, endoderm, mesoderm and ectoderm. So triploblastic coelomate, as you can see, gut region, the endoderm, coelom, it is not completed, and mesoderm, it is split by coelom and you are having the ectoderm. So this is how the increasing level of complexity that is taking place related to the germ layers. So usually coelomates, pseudocoelomates and eucoelomates also we call them. Coelomates means the animal which do not have any coelom. So usually the examples are sponges and cylindrates. Pseudocoelomates means the animals which are having the body cavity, but they are called as pseudocoel, means it is not completed. So we call them as false coelom. And later, eucoelomates are nothing but they consist of true coelom. So we call them as coelomates or eucoelomates. So this is how the germ layers are differentiated. So as I was telling in the types of coelom, coelomates, pseudocoelomates and coelomates. So as you can see in the upper region, the triploblastic organism, how the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm is classified. So the body cavity, as I was telling, the true body cavity is the coelom. So they are called as coeloms, coelomates or the eucoelomates. And pseudocoelom is the body cavity where it is present in the mesoderm and endoderm. Triploblastic animals, they consist of the pseudocoelom, so they are called as pseudocoelomates. And triploblastic animals, they lack in body cavity and usually they are coelomates. And coming to the segmentation and metamerism. or metamerism. So this is nothing but the segmentation is nothing but the type of the body form having linear sequence of units or segments. So if you have seen the insects, for example the earthworm, so they are having minor segments on their body, so those are called as metameric segments. So that type of segmentation is called as metameric segmentation or true metamerism. So usually annelids, they are having this true segmentation. So there are two types, one is metameric segmentation and one more is pseudometamerism or false segmentation. So first one, that is true metamerism or true segmentation. So it is a type of segmentation where external division correspond to the internal division. The body is often divided both externally and internally into number of segments. So we call those segments as metamers. Example is annelids. Coming to pseudo metamerism or false segmentation, so it is found usually in tapeworm. As you can see, there are segments, but it arises from the neck region. So that is, segments of tapeworms are called as proglottids, and they are budded from the neck region. I was telling. So that is called as pseudo metamerism. So usually the segmentation has to take place throughout the body, but it is not taking place throughout the body in tapeworm. It takes place near to the neck region. And coming to the metamerism and pseudo metamerism, so metamerism is nothing but true segmentation, but whereas in pseudo metamerism, that is false segmentation. So segmentation is visible both when body is divided internally and externally. So we can make out how the segmentations are increasing. But whereas here the segmentation is only external. So if the internal segmentation breaks, then only the external segmentation can be also seen in the metamerism. So segments are fused and cannot be separated. But whereas here in pseudo metamerism, segments are loosely bound and can be separated. That is seen in the tapeworms. So most distinct we can make out in annelids, arthropods, example as given, and proglottids, that is the example for pseudo metamerism. Coming to cephalization. So coming to cephalization, the cephalization is nothing but, you should know the term, cephalo means head. So in these animals, usually the bilateral symmetry, there is a greater increase in nerve tissues. So once the level of organization start to increase, then the head region will be prominent. So that is how this type of complexity will be seen. For example, formation of brains or accessory organs like eyes or sensory organs for hearing and tasting. So this is how the cephalization means the formation of head region or the brain taking place, that is called as the cephalization. So this is how you can make out the cephalization in insects, like formation of head and the accessory organs like antenna or the sensory hairs or eyes. But whereas in sponges and the in also the starfish, there is no head region. So that's about this class, as you have studied different types of body layers and cephalization, metamerism, and how the body is divided into different layers like radial, bilateral, and those type of symmetry. So in the next class, we'll be mainly concentrating on different types of definitions for the species, phylogeny, and later we'll know about classification of animals on their basis. So that's about this class. Thank you.